Hey everyone, it's the Nerdy Cooking Lady, and today we're going to be making some pizza. The recipes we're going to be using is from the deep, dark vault of Vault Girl. And of course, one pepperoni pizza, because we all know Lyrical won't eat anything that's food. Anyway, let's get going. First off, I'm only going to make one of the pizzas, buffalo chicken pizza, so unlike in the main recipe, I cubed up two chicken breasts. Now this is about an inch or so, or a little more. I might make them tiny bit smaller just for my bite preferences, but we'll see how it looks once it starts cooking again. Okay, we're going to put our chicken in a smaller saucepan pot to start browning up. And while we do that, we're going to make our homemade blue cheese dressing for the pizza. Alright, we're going to be throwing together our blue cheese dressing. And it is as follows. I have a package of blue cheese. Putting it in the bowl. Last of it out. Likes clinging like that. We put our milk in, and I'll put the complete recipe in the bottom, just for you guys. Giant arm picture, just what y'all wanted. Then we have Dijon mustard. There we go. And our half a cup of mayonnaise. You just grab a spoon for that. There we go. Me, I always use Duke's mayonnaise. People will argue till the cows come home that that's not a real mayonnaise. They're lying to you. If you ever spent 5 minutes in the South, no, it's the only mayonnaise in existence. Alright, we'll use that spoon to get it out, so I'll scrape it off in there. That up thoroughly. Alright. When we're done, we have the wonderfully combined blue cheese dressing, all made at home from scratch. We're going to set that aside to thicken up while we make our chicken buffalo mixture. While we made our dressing, our chicken has been cooking up and, as you see, gathering a lot of broth. I'm going to be dumping some of that out, and we'll be adding our buffalo sauce in a minute. So, we took our chicken off the stove, drained off some of the juice, because we're going to need a little for it to cook. But I'm going to be adding in one of my personal favorite buffalo sauces. Usually I find one at the dollar store that's so very good, but I'm going to have to settle with the one I found yesterday that is my backup. So, we're going to be putting a good amount in here. Remember, we don't want to make buffalo soup. We just want to coat the chicken and let it simmer down. So let's mix that up a little better. Alright, we've got our chicken and our buffalo sauce together. And I put a little tiny bit of broth back in just to help it reduce down. We're going to let that cook until the buffalo sauce starts sticking to the chicken and not being so watery around it. And it'll make a nice coating on it. So we've got our two pizzas put on our pan. We're going to cook this crust for 8 minutes because last time I made pizza, it was still raw in the middle. And that kind of sucked. And then we'll be putting those toppings on. So I'll be back in 8 minutes. All right. Our chicken and buffalo has been boiling together and simmering, and I'm going to let it set a little while our pizza still cooks. We'll put it all together in a minute. Alright, our pizzas are done pre-baking for about 8 minutes. This one got a little too brown, but I'll live. We're going to be making a pepperoni pizza for Lyrical and a buffalo pizza for me. We've got all our fixings over here. Pepperoni is over there. And I'm going to tell you, for the sauce for our buffalo, we took a little bit of the buffalo sauce and our blue cheese dressing that we made, and that's going to be our pizza sauce for our buffalo chicken pizza. Now let's get putting it together. First off, I'm going to spread this sauce around for Lyrical. Had more of an edge on this pizza, but I think it died. It's all right. To the edges I do have. All right. Next, we're going to put some of our cheese. Got my pepperoni. The reason I'm not setting up my camera to take this shot of me putting it together is because my tripod doesn't have a good spot to really look at the oven and see what you're doing sometimes. That, my dad has a lot of great dishes piled up over here, so. Oh well. We're gonna leave that for our pepperoni amount. And last but not least, actually not last, I got a little thing I'm gonna put on top. I'll put a little more pizza, cheese on top. Little tiny sprinkling of some fresh Parmesan. Not Parmesan, parsley. Right, for our buffalo chicken pizza, we're going to be putting our buffalo blue cheese mixture on for the sauce. And once we spread that around, we're going to be putting a light sprinkle of mozzarella on it. And we're gonna tack our chicken and put some in here. You want your chicken not so skimpy unless you like pizza like that, but I like pizza where when you bite into it, you actually get, you know, pieces of meat on it. Alright. I'm gonna put a little sprinkle of Parmesan. Keep saying Parmesan, it's parsley. I'm gonna keep putting a sprinkle of mozzarella cheese on top since I don't want this to be cheese heaven. It's probably already more cheesy than VG made it, but. Oh, well. Put a little tiny sprinkle of that parsley on the top, like I was saying. We're going to cook these, finish them off, and I'll show you what they look like. Alright, our pizza is done cooking, and there's only one thing left to do for mine, which is the buffalo one. Recipe calls for some fresh tomatoes on it. I've cut up some little mini heirloom ones that I found at the store the other day. It looked amazing. And last but not least, put a handful of lettuce on top. I'd honestly never heard of lettuce on pizza, except for the taco one I had once, but it's pretty amazing. So, there you have it. Buffalo chicken pizza and pepperoni pizza for Lyrical. Hehe. I'll be putting the recipes in the comments, and I will take a moment now to mention the Gamers and Geeks Can Cook playlist, where you can find Jopic of Death, Vault Girl, Lyrical Moonraven. Yeah, she cooked once, and the house has recouped, I might add. Quick Smoke, and a hell of a lot of other great cooks. And if you want to put a video into our playlist, it's simple. Cook something awesome, mention the playlist, and voila, you are added to the Hall of Fame. Well, let's try out this pizza once I cut it. I almost forgot to add, we need to put some of our blue cheese dressing on top of our pizza. Now we can cut it. Well, you know what time it is. I moved the other pizza to a pan by itself while it cools off. But as far as mine is concerned, I'm gonna try it. Wow. Sorry, I almost didn't swallow right. That's amazing. And it isn't as hot as I thought it was going to be. The lettuce kind of helps. The blue cheese dressing kind of helps. Wow. I would definitely make this again. This is really good. Might even put a tiny bit more lettuce on top. That and the heat of the pizza is probably making it wilt a little, which kind of sucks. Well, there you have it. Buffalo chicken pizza. And I might even add a side note and see if Lyrical liked hers. Well, I'll see you in the next cooking video. I just wanted to take a moment to mention the Gamers and Geeks Can Cook playlist, put together by FaultGirl145 and Jeffic of Death. If you want to find other cooks like Tanya and myself, you head on over there and you can find Vault Girl's cooking videos, Quick Smoke's cooking videos, and lots of other gamers and geeks that know how to cook. They all have some fabulous recipes. I know I enjoy watching it, so head on over there. I'll slap it in the description for you.